My name is Anna Van Vliet. There were two girls in my class who didn't speak Dutch very well. They had to learn it. They spoke German. I couldn't understand why. It happened to be two Jewish girls. So we got a lot of people crossing the border who were Jewish. And we heard that Germany had invaded Europe. My father said to me, let's put on the radio and hear what they have to say. And there was a very loud German. My mother was a housefrau. If you were married at that time, and your mother had to work. We had hidden two boys, so instead of having seven people in my family, we had nine. But we all had to leave our house because the first things the Germans would do is come to the house and say, my father was a train engineer before the war and during the war. And during the war, so one morning, I wake up early. Sister and I sharing the bedroom, my older sister and I. I hear noise. So they were bombing and shrapnel fell in the street. We were not outside, of course, we were hiding. We knew it was dangerous to be outside when they were dropping all the bombs and the shrapnel of the bombs that we got. So when that thing was over. Now the newspaper, of course, was controlled by the Nazis from 42 to 45. And pro-Nazi things and anti-English as much as you could. But it was possible to have. It was a very interesting newspaper, well read. I'm mostly, interestingly enough, by Jewish people. So when I arrived at the Telegraaf and was involved in sending the newspaper, and I was so surprised how many I had to mail to Westerbork. I only sent newspapers to Westerbork. To Mr. Cohen, to Mr. I don't know who. Now the newspaper, of course, was controlled by the Nazis from 42. I'd come from my office 5 o'clock. The greenhouse was not closed yet, but I was already home. My office closed at 4:30. I delivered a Dagblad Trouw underground newspaper. I didn't realize at the time that there would be danger involved. You were young. You couldn't give a hoot. It had to be done. We listened to Radio Oranje from London, England, where we got the real news in the world. Also about what to do. And by the way, the only time I pat myself on the shoulders, still proud of that, was on Christmas Eve, 1944. I had to do some errands, and the best street to do it in was the Kalverstraat. So I'm downtown, Kalverstraat. Yeah, one came back. And then the war is over.